We will now walk through the 5 steps to do hypothesis testing. And let me quickly add, there's nothing magical about the number 5. I happen to break this procedure into 5 steps. But I've seen other authors use 6 or 7, sometimes 4. The important thing for you to know as a statistics student is that we are all teaching you the same procedure. This is like cutting a pie into 6 or 8 slices. You're still going to get the whole pie. I just happen to cut mine into 5. These 5 steps are outlined in a document that I call the Bear Handout. The little white bear in the Bear Handout will introduce you to the steps and give you lots of useful information about techniques. Sometimes he hangs out with a raccoon, this time it's a squirrel. They're all stuffed animals. So let's get started. Step number 1, select the appropriate statistic. Now this is both the easiest and the most difficult step. As you are learning statistics, this will be the easiest step, because when it comes time to choose the appropriate statistic, the answer will be whatever test we're learning this week. So if we're learning about single sample t-tests, the answer to step 1 will be single sample t-tests. However, in the real world, no one is going to tell you what test to use, and you need to know how to read your data and determine the appropriate test to analyze it. So we begin with this step because it forces us to really look at our data and think about how we're going to proceed. We need to determine which test to use based upon whether our research question is looking for differences between groups or relationships between variables. We need to consider the level of our data, nominal, ordinal, interval, or ratio. We need to consider whether our data are approximately normally distributed or not. Do our samples have approximately equal standard deviations? Have the assumptions for the test we plan to use been violated? All of these are questions that we must answer before we can decide what test to use. And we call this process exploratory data analysis. You will use the diagrams in the Bear Handout to select which statistical test to use. You'll choose the test based on whether you're looking for differences between groups or relationships within groups. For differences, you'll use t-tests or an ANOVA. For relationships, you would use correlation and regression. You'll consider the level of the data. Nominal data will be analyzed with a chi-square. Ordinal data or highly skewed scale-level data might require a non-parametric test. Exploratory data analysis will help you decide what test to choose. However, since we're still learning, I will provide you with clean data sets, most of the time. Notice that the names of the tests are color-coded to match the levels of data, nominal, ordinal, and scale. So for our baby weight example, we will be comparing the Siberian sample mean to the world population mean. And this would be the setup for a single sample t-test.